distinguish between mixture and compound.
As we look around, we can see that most of the matter around us exists as mixtures of two or more components. A mixture is obtained by mixing two or more substances in any proportion, and it shows the properties of the constituent substances. These constituents can be separated easily by physical methods. For example, milk is actually a mixture of water, fat, and proteins. In today's daily life, it would be very difficult to live without using compounds. A compound is a substance composed of two or more different types of elements chemically combined in a fixed proportion. The new substance has totally different properties, and the constituent elements can be separated only by chemical or electrochemical reactions. Water is a good example of a compound. In this experiment, our aim is to distinguish between mixture and compound on the basis of appearance, behavior towards a magnet, behavior towards carbon disulfide, and effect of heating with dilute HCl. Materials required: iron filings, sulfur powder, dilute HCl, carbon disulfide, spatula, magnet, glass rods, boiling tubes, dropper, watch glass, aqueous solution of copper sulfate, and a beaker. Procedure: here we take ferrous sulfide, which is a compound of iron and sulfur, to do the experiment. Upon strong heating, iron is combined with sulfur to form ferrous sulfide. Now, take a mixture of iron and sulfur in a beaker and mix the contents in it using a glass rod. After mixing, we can see the yellow-colored sulfur powder and iron filing separately. Now, take ferrous sulfide in another watch glass and mix it using another glass rod. Here, we cannot see iron filings or sulfur. Thus, we infer that the mixture is heterogeneous and the compound is homogeneous in nature. Now, show a magnet over the watch glass in which the mixture of iron and sulfur has been taken. We can see that iron filings cling to the magnet, which indicates that iron retains its properties. Now, show the magnet over the watch glass in which the compound is taken. We can see that no particle attaches to the magnet, which indicates that iron has lost its properties on forming a compound. Transfer a small quantity of mixture to a clean boiling tube using a spatula and a few drops of carbon disulfide into this boiling tube. Here, sulfur dissolves in carbon disulfide and forms a yellow-colored solution. Now, decant this yellow-colored solution to the china dish. After some time, we can see that the sulfur will reappear as yellow powder, and this indicates that sulfur retains its property. Similarly, transfer a small quantity of compound to a clean boiling tube and add a few drops of carbon disulfide into it and shake the boiling tube well. Here, no change is observed, which indicates that sulfur has lost its original properties after reacting with iron. Now, transfer a small quantity of the mixture to a boiling tube and place it in the test tube rack. Add a few drops of dilute HCl using a dropper. We can see the evolution of glass bubbles, which indicates that iron reacts with dilute HCl and forms hydrogen gas. Fe plus 2HCl gives you FeCl2 plus H2. Similarly, transfer a small quantity of compound to a boiling tube and add a small quantity of dilute HCl into it. A gas evolves in the boiling tube. now. Cork the boiling tube which has a bent tube connected to it. Insert the other end of the bent tube to copper sulfate solution. We can see a black precipitate forming in the copper sulfate solution. Here, ferrous sulfide reacts with dilute HCl to form hydrogen sulfide gas. FeS plus 2HCl gives you FeCl2 plus H2S. The hydrogen sulfide formed reacts with copper sulfate solution to form a black precipitate of copper sulfide. CuSO4 plus H2S gives you CuS plus H2SO4.